Hello everybody, today we are going to see next theorem number 4, powers of theorem number 4. Okay, theorem number 4 we have seen already. What is that theorem? The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, and its converse is if the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, then the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So now here we are going to give the proof of the converse of theorem number 4. Okay, so see here what is given. In given, if the diagonals of a quadrilateral, here see quadrilateral is given ABCD, and diagonals of quadrilateral DB and AC. Okay, so if we will write here quadrilateral ABCD is given, in which DB, and AC are the diagonals. DB and AC are the diagonals. If the diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other, okay, means they intersect here. You will see this point is O. Bisect each other means this and this is equal, and AO and OC are equal. So that also we need to mention here. DO is equal to OB. And AO is equal to CB. AO and CO are equal. Okay. So these things are given. Now we have to write the diagonals of quadrilateral bisect each other. This is this much part we have taken in given. Now what is given? Then the quadrilateral is a parallel. So to prove quadrilateral ABCD, is the parallel, that we have. Okay. Now we know that parallelogram. Parallelogram is what? Opposite sides are equal and parallel. If we are able to do this, opposite sides of this quadrilateral are equal and parallel, then we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a parallel. So accordingly we will give here proof. Okay. So first thing here, if we are going to think about this triangle, AOB, AOD and triangle COB. Okay, or you can take these two triangles. Okay, so I am taking this triangle AOD, AOD and triangle COB, BOC, AO is equal to CO, okay, why? This is given, Angle AOD, this angle and this angle. Angle AOD is equal to angle COB. Why? Because both angles are vertically opposite angles of each other. Okay. And third thing is DO is equal to BO. Why? This is also given. Okay, so two sides are given and one angle, including angle, is given. So we can say in terms of these three things, we can say triangle AOD congruent triangle BOC by SAS, side angle side, Okay, now these two triangles are congruent. Okay, we have given here, but that is very simple. Now, if both the triangles are congruent, then we can say angle OAD or DAO, this angle, is equal to angle OCB, this angle. Okay, angle DAO is equal to angle OCB, Okay, why? By corresponding angle, by CPC, okay, corresponding angles. Okay, by CPCT we said DAO BAO or we can say BAC is equal to ACB. Okay, that also we can write. Instead of that, we can take angle BAC is equal to BAC is equal to angle AC. Angle AC. Both value of both is same. Okay, so here half answer is over. Here see this and this is equal. Angle BAO and OCB are equal. Okay, now we will think about line AC. Okay, so we will say here line AC intersects line AC intersect AD and BC. AD and BC at point A and C respectively. Okay, line AC intersect at point A and C to AD and BC. Okay, so if this line is intersecting AD and BC, line AC is intersecting AD and BC, and alternate interior angles, these are alternate interior angles. If alternate interior angles are same in this equation, then we can say AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. Okay, so that is enough. So now we can write here the same thing, angle BAO is equal to angle OCB. Okay, but both angles are alternate interior angles of each other. Alternate interior angles are each other. Okay, if alternate interior angles are equal, then we can say AD is parallel to BC. AD. So AD is parallel to BC. Okay, so one side we got AD is parallel to BC. And AD is equal to BC also. Okay, AD is equal to BC. Okay, why? Because here we have given proof. Triangles are congruent. Okay, triangles are congruent. AD and BC are the corresponding sides of congruent triangles. So AD and BC are equal and parallel. So AD and BC equal and parallel. Here we have given proof. The same way we can show AB and BC equal. AB and BC equal and parallel. So here not necessary to mention again that. So here we can write this the same way we can show AB is parallel to BC. AB is parallel to BC. Okay, if opposite pair of sides are parallel to each other, then we can say quadrilateral ABCD is the parallel. Okay, this is the theorem. It's follows. Okay, so see carefully and solve this in your notebook. Okay, see here our theorem number 4 is a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay, the quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its one pair of opposite side equal and parallel. Okay, so here we will consider about quadrilateral ABCD. We will consider AB and BC are equal and parallel. Okay, so given quadrilateral ABCD in which AB is equal to BC and AB is equal to BC and AB is parallel to BC. Okay, a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay, so here we have to prove quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. So that is to prove quadrilateral ABCD is the parallelogram. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so directly we cannot show, so we need to do some construction. So we need to join AC or D, any one diagonal we need to construct. So join AC construction, join EC. Okay. So due to diagonal AC, quadrilateral EBCD is divided into two triangles. That is triangle ABC and ABC. Okay. So now in proof we are going to use this proof. Two triangles are there. Okay. So if I want to show these two triangles are congruent. Okay. So first we will take here in triangle ABC, ABC and triangle AEC. Okay. ABC. Triangle ABC. ABC. We have three things. See, AC is the common side for both the triangles, so that is one side. AB and DC are equal, that is given. And if these two lines are parallel and this is a transversal, so we can say this angle, angle DCA and angle CAB are equal. So three things we have. Okay, so first we will take AC is equal to AC, common side. Common side for both the triangles. Then we will take CAB, angle CAB. CAB, CAB is equal to CAB is equal to ACD, angle ACD. Because AC is transversal. Okay, BC is parallel to AB. Okay. BC is parallel to AB and AC is transversal. AC is a transversal. Okay, so alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Okay, and third thing, AB is equal to BC. AB and BC are equal. AB is equal to BC. Okay, so by side angle side, by SAS criteria, we can see triangle ABC, congruent triangle ABC by side angle side. By SAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Okay. If triangles are congruent, then one pair is given. We need to show this. Okay. So now we can say this angle, angle DAC is equal to angle ACB. Okay, angle DAC, angle DAC is equal to angle ACB. Okay, by CPCB, corresponding angle, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so this and this angle is equal. By CPCB we can do that. Okay, if these two angles are congruent, then now we will use AD. AD is parallel to BC. We can show with the help of this. Okay. If DAC and ACB, DAC and ACB are equal, okay. So here we can write line AC intersects, line AC intersect AD and BC, AD and BC at point A and C respectively, okay, A and C. And here we said here angle DAC is equal to angle ACB. Okay. So these both angles are alternate interior angles also. So here we can mention, or here we can write alternate interior angles. If alternate interior angles are equal, then we can say AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. Okay. So this is, we will say, this is first one, and this I am saying here second one. Okay, so from second, and which is given, AB is parallel to BC. Okay, AB is parallel to BC, that is given, and AD is parallel to BC. With the help of these two things, we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a parallel. Okay, so now here I am taking AB is parallel to BC. So that is I am saying third one. So from this reason is given. Okay. So from second and third, we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a parallel. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallel. Okay.
Okay, so our first problem is show that if the diagonals of quadrilateral bisect each other at right angles, then it is a homus. Okay, figure is not given, we have to construct according to the given information. Okay, once again see, show that if the diagonals of quadrilateral, here quadrilateral is given, ABCD is a quadrilateral, diagonals BD and AC, diagonals of a quadrilateral bisect each other means this and this is bisect each other. So here intersection point we will take O, bisect each other at right angles. One more thing is given, all are bisecting at right angles, means all the four angles where both the diagonals are bisecting, all the four angles which are formed, all angles are right. Okay, so then it is a rhombus. We have to prove this is a rhombus. Okay, so first we will take given things. What is given? We will think about that. In quadrilateral ABCD, in which what is given? BO is equal to OD. BO is equal to DO. OA, AO is equal to OC. AO equals to OC. As well as angle AOB is equal to angle BOC equals to 90 degree. All four angles we can write at a time. AOD, angle AOD is equal to angle COD is equal to 90 degree. Okay, all are right angles. Now we have to prove that quadrilateral, to prove quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Rhombus means what? What is the main property of rhombus which we need to show here? That is, all the four sides are equal in length. Okay, means here we have to show AB is equal to BC is equal to DC is equal to AD. If we are able to show this, then we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, so that is our target. So we can say here in short, AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD. All the both sides of equal length. Okay, now we will think about proof. We will think about proof. Okay, if the diagonals of quadrilateral bisect each other at right angles, so here we can say we will use these two triangles, triangle AOB and BO. So any two consecutive triangles we can use. Okay, so now I am taking here triangles AOB and triangle COB, AOB and COB. If we are thinking about these two triangles, so easily we can prove that both the triangles are congruent. See here, AO and OC are equal because it is given. Both angles BOA and BOC are right angles, and then BO is common side for both the triangles. So by side angle side we can say both the triangles are congruent. So here we can mention AO is equal to CO. Why? Given angle AOB is equal to COB, angle COB. Okay, each 90 degree. Okay, that is they have told us. And BO is equal to BO. Okay, common side for both the triangles. Common for both the triangles. So we can say triangle AOB congruent triangle COB by side angle side, by SAS, side angle side, both the triangles are congruent. Okay, now we have given here proof, triangles are congruent. So now from this we can say if both the triangles are congruent, we can say AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC. AB and BC are equal. Why AB and BC are equal? By CPCP, corresponding parts of congruent. Okay, corresponding parts of congruent. These two triangles are congruent, so AB and BC are corresponding sides, and both sides are equal. So by CPCP we can say AB and BC are equal. Okay, but quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, here AB, the diagonals bisect each other. So definitely quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. So here we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, because diagonal bisect one another. Understood? If ABCD is a parallelogram, then what we will get with the help of this? If this is a parallelogram, why we say this is a parallelogram? Because diagonal bisect one another. Okay, so ABCD is a parallelogram. If it is parallelogram, then we can say AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CD and AD is equal to BC. AD is equal to BC. Okay, because opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram are always equal. Okay, but here we got AB is equal to BC, which are consecutive sides. So this is I am saying here first one. AB is equal to BC, but AB is equal to BC. So here this is from 1. AB and BC are equal. As this is a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. This and this is equal. AB and BC are equal. AB and BC are equal. Okay, and BC and AD are equal. So from this we can say AB, but AB and BC are equal. So we can say, so AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD. Okay, so quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus because that is one of the property of rhombus. All the sides are equal in length. Okay? Thank you very much.